हेलो क्लास नाइन स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस पार्ट टू ऑफ द चैप्टर फाइव, दैट इज साइबर सेफ्टी। इन वीडियो यू विल लर्न द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक लाइक सेफ्टी ब्राउजिंग द वेब एंड यूजिंग द सोशल, एंड लाइक हाउ टू सेफली ब्राउजिंग और सोशल मीडिया नेटवर्क, विच आर द सेफ्टी वी मेजर व्हाइल वी यूज द कंप्यूटर और इंटरनेट। Then what is computer virus and various type of computer virus and how to protecting your computer virus. So this all point you will discuss in this video. First we discuss safety measure while you using the computer and internet. So what we have to do, like we have to install proactive software like antivirus. We need to update regularly because this is very important from preventing any unauthorized person or viruses. Clear? Second is choose strong password. We have to put our strong password. Strong password means use the special character, alphabet, numeric. So password becomes strong, as well as we have to change on regular basis. Backup of our regular data or important data. Okay, we need to take the backup. Control access to your machine, like do not leave your computer unattended or log on, especially on the public place. So never leave our system when we use on public place. Use email and internet safely, like do not open the email with the attachment or link from the unknown people, like there is unknown people sending the link. So never have to open the link and never share your email address with the unknown person as well as unknown website. Same way, use firewall. So what is a firewall? Firewall is a most basic way to safeguard your computer from being accessed by the burglar. So what we have to always on our firewall, so no one can access your personal information. So it is a very important. There is a type of hardware like software firewall and hardware firewall. So I am talking about software firewall. Okay, it does prevent a computer system from unauthorized person to viewing the sensitive data. So we have to follow this all instruction for proper and better usage of computer. Okay, now next is safely browsing the web and using the social media network. Like we are using the various social media networks, so what we have to do, so general like cyber ethics are there, like OB to copyrights law. Like if we like copy any information, so always give the location or always give the path, like from where we have take this information, specify the path. Respect the others on social media platform, be tolerant and careful, like never share like wrong information on internet, never responding on mails or chat. So we have to careful whenever we use the social media network. Few social networking cyber ethics, that is never share your screen name, like never upload your own photo, then never share your personal information. So this all small thing that we need to care. Hopefully everyone understand this also. Topic next is email netiquette, that is email ethics. So which are the email ethics, like whenever we use the email address, what we need to follow, like use the computer counter safe. What is meant by count say, be like respectful to the others while sending an emails or chatting on the internet, like give respect to everyone, do not shout on mail, pay attention to the language, like never use like capital letter, always use the small letters, and check spelling and grammars, take look before sending the message. So few things like we need to care whenever we use the email on internet. Now a very important topic, that is computer viruses that actually damage our programs or our systems, like our software side systems. So what is a computer virus? A virus is a small self-replicated software program that infects the computer without the permission of the owner. So computer virus is a one type of software program that is designed by hacker or someone else, and without owner permission it is like coming in your computer. So what is a virus stand for? Virus stand for Vital Information Resource Under Siege. So this is the full form of the virus. So now we discuss one by one. There are various type of computer viruses. First is boot sector virus. So you know that whenever we start the computer, first the computer will boot. Okay, so this is also called as a system viruses. Boot sector virus are also known as a system viruses. This type of virus attack the boot sector. You know about now what is boot. So it is a attack in our boot sector by attaching itself to the DOS boot sector on master boot record on hard disk. So like it is a attack in our boot system or on that is available on hard disk. So and this is also known as a system virus file. Next type of computer virus is file virus. So file virus attack and modify the executable or program files. Like if we are using the different programs, so programs are save.exe or .com, clear? So this virus are attacking on our program file that is created after after executing. .exe file that is executed whenever we run the program, so this file is created. So file virus attack on this program. Next is macro virus. What is macro virus? These are written in the scripting language for Microsoft program like Word, Excel. Okay, so macro virus is attacking in a Microsoft programs, like it is a attack in a Word file or Excel file. Clear? So what actually this will do, it will create unnecessarily characters between two words or between two characters. So it will damage our spreadsheet or documents program. So hopefully everyone understand these three types of virus. Now that is email virus. It is a type of virus that spread through the attachment to an email. Like if you open an unknown person link on email, so through which maybe virus will come in our computer. Torsion virus. So they claim to perform some useful function. What they say? They say we are like performing some useful function for you, but actually this damaging our systems or systems like our deleting our files. Okay, so this is a Torsion virus. A program name waterfalls.scr is an example of Torsion horse. Like you download some wallpaper from the internet, and this wallpaper when you install, then this type of virus are coming. So and actually due to, through this various files are deleted in our system. Next is computer worm. Computer worm is a self-replicated computer program that copies itself to the other computer on the network. So computer worm virus are spread through the network. It will spread from one computer to the another computer. Clear? So it create a duplicate copy of your program. Next is spyware. What is a spyware? Spyware is a computer software that is installed secretly on a computer to learn the browsing habit. What this virus will do, like what we are like using through the browsing, like we know that there are browsing means like we are using the Mozilla or Google Chrome, and whatever we search during the day or time period, so everything it is just secretly check that what we are searching. For example, if you open any our bank websites and we enter the ID and password, so through the spyware virus it will hack our personal detail, try to hack our personal details. Next is malware. What is a malware? Malware is derived from the words malicious and software. Okay, it is a consist of these two words, malicious and software. This term is used to denote a variety of forms of interchanging software or program code. Actually, what this virus will do, it will like damage our program code. Okay, it will interfere in a software or in our program code, and it will try to unchange our program code. So that is known as a malware virus. And last is spam. Spamming is a process of flooding the inbox with so many copies of same message. Like multiple messages are coming in our inbox of same message. So what this will do? This is one type of virus. When we share our email address with unknown people or unknown websites, so through that this spam attack is happening. So this is also known as a like bombing of mail. Hopefully everyone understand all type of computer viruses. Now we talking next point. That is protecting our computer from the viruses. So as we know, we have to like regular updated antivirus. We need to install and regularly update it. Use updated anti-spyware technology. As you know that spyware is a virus. To prevent this virus, we have to regularly update the anti-spyware technology. So this is a one software that we have to use. Keep the firewall on, as I already say. Keep your operating system up to date. So few things we have to follow. Hopefully everyone understand this whole topic. Thank you.